Hello friends, today we will be covering the third division of trigeminal nerve, which is the mandibular nerve. So the mandibular nerve is the largest division of the trigeminal nerve. It contains both the sensory as well as the motor fibers. So we will start its route from the cranium to the areas where it supplies. Starting from the trigeminal ganglion. Trigeminal ganglion is present in our brain, from where mainly three divisions are formed. One is the ophthalmic nerve, which supplies the eye portion. The maxillary nerve, which supplies the upper part of our mouth, or we call it maxilla. And the mandibular nerve. This mandibular nerve came out of the cranium through a foramen known as the foramen ovale. Now, first of all, we'll talk about its first part, that is from the main trunk. So the main trunk of the mandibular nerve gives two branches, that is the nervus spinosus and nerve to the medial pterygoid. This nervus spinosus is a sensory branch, also known as your meningeal nerve. It goes back to the brain and supply the meninges. Whereas the nerve to the medial pterygoid is a motor branch which supplies the medial pterygoid muscle, which is a mesenteric muscle, which is the muscle of mastication. Now, here it divides into the two parts. One is the anterior division, which is a thin division, and another one is the posterior division. The anterior division gives all the motor branches except one sensory branch. It gives the mesenteric nerve, which supplies the mesenteric muscle, the deep temporal nerves, anterior and the posterior deep temporal nerves, which supply the temporalis muscle, and the nerve to the lateral pterygoid, which supplies the lateral pterygoid muscle. There is a branch goes down, which is known as the buccal nerve, which is a sensory division. Now coming to the posterior division, it mainly give three branches: auriculotemporal nerve, lingual nerve, and the inferior alveolar nerve. In this group, all the branches are sensory in nature except one. So first of all, we'll talk about the auriculotemporal nerve. This auriculotemporal nerve forms a loop around an artery. Now you people will tell which artery is it around which the auriculotemporal nerve forms a loop and then goes to supply the area in front of the external orbital fissure, then the temporomandibular joint, and the skin all over that area. So I will reveal this answer in the next class. Now the lingual nerve. This lingual nerve is a very short branch. To this, the submandibular ganglion hangs, and also the caudal tympani nerve, which is a branch of your facial nerve, joins to it to give the fibers, so that they lead to the secretion of the saliva from the salivary glands. We will discuss this details later. Now the third nerve, that is the inferior alveolar nerve. So this inferior alveolar nerve further divides into the two halves. One is the one which enters the inferior orbital foramen, that is the inferior alveolar nerve, which supplies the whole of your mandible, and one branch which separates from it, that is the nerve to myelohyoid muscle. This is the motor division of this group. Now, this inferior alveolar nerve, its main trunk supplies your posteriority, that is your molars and the premolars of your mandible. When the mental foramen came, a branch came out, which is the mental nerve, which supplies the skin of the cheek and the chin of that area. Whereas the nerve which goes straight in this canal, that is the incisive nerve, which supplies the incisors and the canines of your mandible. So this is whole is the mandibular nerve. Mandibular nerve is also known as the nerve of your cat of your nine tails. So you should remember its branches and its divisions. This is very important as the exam point of view. Thank you. Please like, share, subscribe to my channel. Thank you.